Hey, why don't we play audio from this program?
Yeah, I want to find out what this is all about.
All right.
Thanks, Jim.
This seems like a... What happened?
I don't know. I just heard Jim making some noises from a certain area that wasn't his mouth. Can I have that Lysol, Danny? It's right there.
It's my stuff
here.
He knows.
Thanks. Yeah. And
Jim's blinking a
this
lot.
This is for my unstuffy nose.
My
just going to spray a little Lysol.
It's a tickle.
Where?
In the back of my head. That sinus drip tickle.
No, that tickle was probably your sphincter.
Well, that was my my body gets very tense when I'm yeah. drippy.
We're the worst, man. We just had like, I don't know, almost 2 weeks off. We had plenty of time to be sick during our time off.
Yep.
All right, here we go. Different kinds of offenders. Okay, listen to this.
Some people believe sex offenders cannot be changed. Some experts say not true. They say they're doing it right here in the Portland area.
Well, that's right. It's
right there in Portland. They're finally deciding to do something.
Right in Portland. Good for them.
Logging and curing sex offenders. What a great area of the country.
Right here in the Portland area.
Well, that's right. It's not the same treatment for every sex offender. The psychiatrist and the social worker behind this program in Portland say they divide things up between two different kinds. The predatory sex offender who is out looking to grab kids and what they call the situational, someone who might have done a one-time molestation in, say, a home setting, which is considered to be less severe.
Oh.
And they say it's this second group, this less severe group, that responds very well to their kind of treatment.
The manipulative,
why doesn't the first group
guy
home
that
setting.
Would, home setting? What the hell does that even mean?
Some creepy neighbor or something that
t- right,
someone
right.
trusts him?
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. That's good. They should cure him with a bullet right to his forehead.
The smell of cordite.
Boom.
That's
right.
It. It's over.
By the way, someone is definitely lingering a little bit longer today. He writes, "Did the flu lady from Juneau make Opie sick? Damn her."
Oh.
I guess ducking down in my seat as she was sneezing behind me
didn't work.
Didn't prevent me from getting it. How many days does it take, by the way?
I don't think the CDC recommends just ducking
yeah.
to get out of the way of somebody
well,
sneezes.
I played like bank robber too, though.
I don't think that works either.
Bank robber and
you ever see healthcare
going,
workers
and going
doing
low
that?
In my seat. That should have worked.
Contagions.
That stuff
you ever see them just pull their shirt over their nose? You know why they don't do that?
Why?
Because it doesn't work.
It makes you feel like it might, though.
Yeah.
That's all that matters. How long does it take? If someone's sneezing behind you at a movie.
A sneeze travels at well over 180 miles an hour.
Thank you, Anthony.
So I don't think you could cover up.
In time.
In time, yeah.
Does the sneeze itself make you sick?
I would think so, sure.
Why?
A lot of germs
why?
Coming out of
why?
Your nose.
Why?
Because you got all those viral germs.
Really?
Those little viruses shooting out of the nose. Oh, Jesus, don't sneeze. Just scared myself.
Jimmy, for the rest of the show, just make believe you're going to sneeze and look at it.
Oh, it's not that hard. I can feel a sneeze coming.
Isn't it easy to make it look like you're going to sneeze, but to actually do an authentic acting sneeze is hard.
Watch. Tell me if this makes you paranoid.
But you can go...
Tell me if this makes you paranoid.
Hold on. And then that's all you get. What a tool.
How's this? I put my finger up and I go, ah! Choo! I look around like everyone's scared.
Bravo.
That's very good coming from me.
Yes, of course.
All right, here we go. Let's find out more about the sex offender program here.
Mm.
Spend an hour in this chair, alone, in this room, and you'll feel sick, afraid, ashamed. That's just what the doctors want.
Opie and Anthony show? A guest.
Yeah, that'll make the intro to the show, huh?
Please. Oh, yeah, let me hear that again. That does sound like an intro for this show.
Do we have, like, Opie and Anthony? I'll do Opie and Anthony guy.
Spend an hour in this chair, alone, in this room, and you'll feel sick, afraid, ashamed.
The Opie and Anthony show.
Perfect.
Spend an hour in this chair, alone, in this room, and you'll feel sick, afraid, ashamed. That's just what the doctors want.
It worked very well. My arousal... has gone down very much.
Oh,
very much with
ew.
You creep. Here, smell this. Here, I think this one might do it. Okay, look at this picture. Are you aroused? Yes. Now smell this. Okay. Next. Okay. I want you to take a whiff of this. Now, this is more of a subtle smell, but look at this picture. Yes, it's of a high school cheerleading team. And what are you feeling? All right, smell this. All right, there's two gone. Okay, one more. Okay, here, open up this little yearbook. Now look, yeah, you see that. Okay, it is the drill team, right? Now you're feeling, what are you feeling? Yeah, arousal. Okay, here, it's a very faint scent. Oh, what a creep that guy was. Feeling arousal.
My arousal. My arousal. Yuck.
Has gone down very much.
Very much
with that.
John was molested by his uncle and went on to molest his girlfriend's grandchildren.
Ah, the circle of life.
There it is. The circle of life. Oh, are we a bunch of ghouls? The circle of life.
Why don't we talk about that circle of life, huh?
I touched you, Simba.
Now you will go on to touch.
There it is.
All right, get that queued up. We're going to replay it. Grandchildren and grandparents are standing in a circle like a bunch of elephants with the trunks.
People are suggesting I drink that airborne stuff. I don't know if that works.
No, it's emergency is better.
I don't even know if the creators know if it works.
They've sold a lot.
They sure have.
The crying king.
Very good.
What's that, Danny?
All right, E-Rock, you ready? Me and you, working together. Here we go.
My arousal has gone down very much.
Arousal dazzle.
John was molested by his uncle and went on to molest his girlfriend's grandchildren.
Yes, certainly is.
I like turtles.
You use your tongue prettier than a $20 whore.
Ah, the circle of life, yes.
Yeah.
This is what it sounds like when doves cry.
Is that supposed to be sexy?
All right.
It's in the hole!
Good old circle of life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very much with that.
John was molested by his uncle and went on to molest his girlfriend's grandchildren. He went to prison for more than 8 years. Now he's out and working to stay out.
The individual showed quite a significant rise in the penile trace.
Offenders like him put on this gauge, like a lie detector for their genitals, showing how much images
it's lying. A lie detector. Come on now.
If it's false, a light lights up, and if it's true, you have to wipe the floor off.
I'm thinking more Pinocchio.
Oh, man. Okay, so you can picture what this thing does. Oh, look, a commercial for the Lion King on television. What a coinky-dink. Yeah, you can picture how this thing works.
Sure.
Ooh. It kind of looked like a circular ring.
Sure.
And it looked like it was hooked up to a seismograph. And it would measure certain things.
Wouldn't that be intimidating enough where if you were shown something that you weren't supposed to be aroused by, that you're kind of thinking that?
I guess not for these guys.
Than? No?
Why are you asking?
Oh, it's the opposite effect. Well, Than was coming over.
Oh.
I like giving him a little preface like, Than. He's walking up to the mic, Than.
Wait, so what happens after you got this thing on?
Well,
they show you pictures, and then what happens? If you get,
I guess that gauges,
you get a reaction.
It probably gauges what we like to call the twitch. You know?
But do they zap you?
No!
They're using smells.
They're using smell.
Oh, we're not to the smell part yet?
No.
Oh.
Penile trace. Offenders like him put on this gauge, like a lie detector for their genitals, showing how much images of children arouse them and how to stop it.
Women must just hate us. Like, this reporter having to do this is probably like, this is disgusting. We have to put a ring around men so they could gauge how aroused they are.
And then they show them, like, some pictures that you would get arrested for. These guys are getting, like, a free ticket.
Free show?
Free show.
It's probably not that graphic. I bet it's probably, like, really
frolicking
subtle.
Pictures.
Yeah.
Pictures of frolicking.
Frolicking.
Why
these guys
are
just creeps. 8 years.
Well, he should still. You molest.
Of course, he should.
Grandchildren. He should be. He's currently in jail, having his teeth kicked in. That's where he should die. Once you molest grandchildren, you should never get out.
There should be one smell therapy he's getting.
Yes.
And it's that awful scent of when someone's done.
Yeah. Or it smells like that hair product that certain ethnic groups will use as your face is in their pillow.
Well, this just in, the gauge is just a pair of sweatpants.
Want to hear more?
Of course. Can't stop now.
He sees his arousal as its beginning, and he can learn to identify the physiological changes, the feelings that go along with very low levels.
Absolutely.
Babble. This guy needs something hooked up to him, and people need something hooked up to him so they could judge and gauge if this guy's being turned. If this guy even needs this, there's a problem.
They have the highest recidivism rate. They always reoffend.
Yeah.
You cannot rehabilitate kid touchers.
That's not. You know what?
You can't
gouge their eyes out.
No, because then
then they cannot see.
Everyone,
they can still like hold out candy and go, "Anybody hungry?" And someone will show up. They just shouldn't get out of jail.
People are trying to figure out what the smell is in the smell therapy. Let's go to Jared. Jared.
Jay Reed.
Hey, you. How you doing, guys? How about E-Rock's breath?
Oh no, that's. Even though these guys are awful people, you know, there is a line. Yeah. Cruel and unusual punishment is not allowed in this country, sir.
I love that they'll never forget.
E-Rock, that's very hurtful, isn't it, teasing like that? I don't go for that.
Thank you.
Microphone.
Let's go to Jeff in Chicago. Jeff in Chicago, who used to listen to us on WCKG. What's up, Jeff?
Ring device that uses like shows like a seismograph. That's the same thing that Bret Michaels used on Rock of Love when.
They hooked Bret Michaels up to this thing.
Oh, to see if he was getting.
And then he had the girls like doing phone sex.
That's cool. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's it.
All right. So it's that. I guess you're right. I guess it's that device. So. All right. Let's find out more here.
He sees his arousal as its beginning, and he can learn to identify the physiological changes, the feelings that go along with very low levels of arousal, and intervene there.
Intervene with a sudden fright.
Stop!
With cayenne pepper in their mouths, with the smell.
What was that?
Tablespoonful of cinnamon.
But what was the stop?
Yeah, you say stop.
What?
In the name of inappropriate love.
It might have been just a soundbite for the, I think it was just a soundbite for the piece.
Oh.
In there.
Intervene with a sudden fright.
Stop!
With cayenne pepper in their mouths, with the smell of liquid roadkill so foul, some offenders become ill.
An association now of revulsion, fear, anxiety, aversion.
This is Clockwork Orange.
This is
a Clockwork Orange. What a genius Anthony Burgess was to write this. They held him up. If you haven't seen Clockwork, they opened his eyes and they gave him an experimental drug, the Ludovico treatment.
Yes.
And they made him watch videos of violence and rape, and the drug affected him adversely. Mm-hmm. So in real life, when confronted with sex or violence, he would want to puke.
Yeah.
That's exactly what this is.
That's what they're trying to do. They're trying to make it so that when he does see something inappropriate that arouses him, he will then link that with the roadkill and the cayenne pepper and not be aroused.
Will not work.
I don't think so, unless you take every child in his neighborhood and hang a dead albatross around its neck.
Yeah, you got the parents hanging roadkill from their kids as they go off to school.
How about this? If you don't know, like if you can't control yourself from molesting a kid, I don't understand how like the taste of pepper is going to stop you. It's not going to stop you.
Yeah.
Exactly. I always wondered what one of these would taste like with a little pepper.
Let's say hi to John in Staten Island. Staten Island is it's a weird place in the New York area that we don't know much about.
Yes.
Really? What is this?
Staten Island. I think
like Land of the Lost?
I think they do science experiments over there.
Oh.
Something's going on with Staten Island. I drive through it every once in a while, and it scares me.
Not very quickly.
It seems like the sun never shines.
One highway ass island.
It just, the sun doesn't shine on Staten Island.
No.
Watch. Go drive there today. You'll see. Nothing but clouds.
Not really shining much anywhere today.
I know. That's why I picked today to do that bit.
Good idea.
John, what's up?
You know, all of this sounds just like the crap they did in the 50s with old people that were gay. You know, electroshock therapy, this, that. It doesn't work.
How'd that work out?
Well, for me, it didn't work too well. But I don't know about anything else.
Did they really do that back in the day?
Yeah, they were using the stupid things. You know, my God.
Yeah, you know how they had to do that. Wow. We must try to cure the homosexual with smell therapy. Although the worse the smell, the more gay they got.
All right, John, thank you. Let's say hi to Scott in Boston listening on BCN. What's up, Scott?
What's up, fellas?
Hey,
good morning.
Good morning.
This lady sounds like the perv whisperer. You ever seen that dog whisperer show? Scott!
Yeah, she's like treating them like the dogs.
Yeah. Sounds just like the perv whisperer.
Like the dogs they are. Yeah. All right, Scott.
Sick.
Become ill. An association now of revulsion, fear, anxiety, aversion. So that the deviant stories and the deviant thoughts and the images of children or of aggression become a turn off rather than a turn on.
Excuse me.
Too, and can carry their own bottles of rotting meat to help out when they're not at the clinic.
Oh, my God.
Rotting meat. I need to smell rotting meat. I'm by a school. Shouldn't the aversion...
You're driving by... I know you're trying... Since the visual, you're driving by the school, you're starting to get that urge.
No!
You're trying to get the lid of the jar
off. Open up your glove compartment trying to find your rotting meat vial. Shouldn't the aversion and anxiety have come from the 8 years you spent in prison?
Yes.
Shouldn't that be enough to make you think, hey, I shouldn't be doing this? Last time I did, I spent 8 years in prison.
Is this Portland, Oregon?
Yeah.
It figures.
Very,
very
open-minded,
liberal,
very liberal, free-form, kind of.
Try to cure the animal.
That's where you go for animal sex, too, by the way.
Portland, Oregon?
I think so, right? Isn't it Oregon?
Washington,
Pacific Northwest. People love having sex with animals in the Pacific Northwest. Can I say that?
I think I can. I think at this point, psychology shouldn't be offered as a major in college.
Figures it's Portland. Just figures.
Yeah. What?
I don't know. Fans coming very close today.
Missed it?
No, it is funny. They get confused and pitch a tent every time they drive by a landfill.
let's go to Jason in Carolina. Jason.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Love you. Love the show.
Yeah.
Hey, one of the movies they're showing these guys is Two Kids, One Sippy Cup.
Oh, wow.
Funny.
Very good, bro. Nice. A lot of Boston calls today. What's up with that? Go, Pats, go. What's up, Paul?
Hey, Paul R. Nelson's opponent funded that test. Linger longer.
Yeah, do we have that old Paul R. Nelson commercial where he...
accuses...
No, was he the...
Is he being accused or was
he
accused?
Was accusing.
No, he was accusing. That's right, because Paul R. Nelson was the upstanding citizen...
He was accusing the other guy of the Eskimo stuff.
Yeah. Paying for all kinds of sexual testing.
It's worth playing before we go to break here.
He even wanted to pay for electrodes. Remember that?
Yeah. Why don't we talk to John here? John says treatment videos help a lot as well.
This is, this is the creepy guy with the
this
voice.
This is the creepy guy.
Ugh.
I've been waiting for you, child molester.
Staying out of prison is strong.
What was that?
That was a clip from one of these videos that they make them watch as part of therapy. It's just some guy in like a jail cell. He's like mopping and he goes, hey, I've been waiting for you, child molester.
Child molester.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
How does this work?
It doesn't.
Are you kidding me?
It doesn't, because the guy goes to beat you up and you're like, I saw your movie. And then he likes you.
Yeah, you are great.
Hey, you're famous.
I really felt the fear.
I've been waiting for you, child molester.
Staying out of prison is strong motivation for John, who describes real prison much like this treatment video he had to watch again and again.
Uh-oh.
I know a dozen guys in here just cut your throat as soon as look at you.
While I was in prison, I was attacked by a group of people who didn't like sex offenders.
Yeah.
Oh, damn them.
This needs to be spiced up a little bit. Hold on a minute. Hold on, please.
A little spice, some little, cayenne pepper,
a little cayenne
perhaps.
Liquid roadkill.
Yeah, a little vial of dead meat.
I'm scared of you!
Rotting meat. Of course, okay. Dead meat would be dead.
Yeah.
It was silly of me to even suggest that.
I've been waiting for you, child molester.
Staying out of prison is strong motivation for John, who describes real prison much like this treatment video he had to watch again and again.
I know a dozen guys in here just cut your throat as soon as look at you.
While I was in prison, I was attacked by a group of people who didn't like sex offenders.
Okay, all I've seen them use screwdrivers, ice picks, and a few handmade guns.
I have a steel eye socket, a steel cheekbone, screws in my face.
I'll be waiting.
My opinion on going back to jail is very much, it isn't going to happen, no matter what I have to do.
He and other sex offenders get extra intervention through these videos, alternating a fantasy story with horrifying images like castration surgery and a victim splashing a sex offender's face with acid. Now John is through with his treatment. He believes he's reached a new stage in his life where he is healthy and happy.
I'm cured, me brother.
And paying taxes, but like an addict, always ready to watch for the need to intervene.
If you're not honest with yourself deep inside, then you can't make any changes.
Once you're molesting kids, you will always be a kid toucher. That's it.
There's no walking away from that.
He's doing
proof. It's been proven.
He's doing less time than guys who commit an armed robbery, where all of us could say go to a bank and rob it. Those guys get more time than a guy who molests his girlfriend's grandchildren.
Yeah. How is that?
Hmm. Well, there you go. I don't. Seems a little weird.
It will work.
You think that's working at all?
Yeah, until somebody who they do it on murders a kid. There'll be something like that, and then they'll just scrap the whole stupid progressive idea of rehabilitating these animals.
All that said to me, especially that creepy guy when he said, you know, I won't go back to prison. I'll do whatever it takes. That doesn't mean sniffing roadkill. That means killing the child so they won't say anything.
Right, exactly.
That's the first thing that popped into my mind when that creep said that.
You know who I feel sorry for?
Let me think.
The
E-Rock.
No.
No?
Never. The roadkill on the side of the road.
Yes. Being just sniffed upon by some aroused child.
Haven't they suffered enough?
Creep.
They just want to cross the highway.
Oh, much better now. Could you direct me to a dead squirrel, please? I'm feeling aroused.
Yes. I have an ache.
Yes, my sensor is going off. I need some rotting meat. I'm fresh out.
Wouldn't you just not shower ever?
Where do you get that, too? Do you have to get a prescription?
Isn't that
do
they a dead
have that at Rite Aid?
You're a pedophile? Pick up 2 vials of rotting meat. One of those.
Keep the kids away.
You're online at Dwayne Reed just whistling along to the music.
Yeah. I phoned in a prescription last night for the rotting meat.
Right.
Do you have that?
The guy in the back is trying to shove a squirrel into a pill bottle.
Just doesn't work.
This reminds us of an old clip